In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Today we're looking at the eighth episode of John chapter 5, 1 to 15. And we see here today that the Lord goes and finds the man. He goes and finds the man after this man was being persecuted and questioned by the Jews. He goes and he finds him. And he gives him a word that is very, very strong. He says, "See, you've been made well. See, I said a word and you were healed. See, I have now given you life. I have restored you. I have healed you." Then he says, "Sin no more, lest a worse thing come upon you." And here it may sound that the Lord is kind of like threatening him. You know, he's giving him a warning. Don't mess up, because if you do, you're going to get paralyzed again. You're going to sit by that pool again. And yet here I hear the words of love. I hear the words of truth. He is telling the man that his illness, his paralysis, was not the issue. Rather, it was sin that was the issue in his life. And is that not true for us? The issue is not the difficult circumstances that we are in. The issue is not the pain or the suffering or the illness that we have. Rather, the issue is sin. And sin here, not in a moral sense, as in, "Oh, I did a bad thing," or "there was a bad event," or "I swore," or "I did this or did that, and that was a sin." Rather, sin is the moving away from life. Sin is the moving away and turning our attention away from God, who is life, obedience to His word, to His way, and rather moving towards ourselves, moving towards non-existence, moving towards the ego. He's telling him, "Sin no more," not because he wants him to be a good person, not because he wants him to be an ethical and moral, pious person, but rather he's telling him, "You have been healed. You have had an experience of life. You have met me, the Logos, the Word of God, life himself. Now do not move away from me. Do not step outside of the life that I have given you." And what is this worst thing that is to come to you? Many would say that he would be paralyzed again. But I believe that the worst thing that can come upon you is sin itself. So many people think that sin is pleasurable and enjoyable, and it's like the best, it's awesome to experience, you know, fulfilling all of your pleasures and all your desires. And yet, without fail, sin leaves a person in a state of emptiness, corruption, and death. More painful and worse than paralysis is spiritual paralysis. More painful and more devastating is sin itself. I remember reading that one of the fathers said that, you know, sin is punishment enough for the soul, for it distorts and it causes pain to the human soul to sin. But even more ultimately, what is this worst thing that can come upon those who willingly sin, who willingly leave the Lord, who refuse to repent and to return? It is to enter into the eternal realm in that state of fallenness. Lord, be merciful to us. Lord, do not allow this to happen. You told this man to sin no more, and you are telling us today to sin no more. To not allow ourselves to wallow in sin, to not pursue sin, but rather now that we have been healed, now that we have been baptized, now that we have repented and received confession, here now in this moment, in the fullness of time, do not sin, lest a worse thing come upon you. Lord, be merciful to us. Fill us with your grace that we no longer even desire to sin, that sin would reveal its ugly face to us, that we would not fantasize about fulfilling our desires and our lusts and our greed and then when those things don't happen and things don't go our way, anger enters and our worlds are torn because we do not have what we want. Rather, Lord, heal us. And do not allow us to enter into that state where we are moving away from life. May today be a day where we live out the holiness that God has called us to by being in Him. Lord, we are yours. Let it be done to us according to your word. Have a beautiful day.